morning, students. Today we will continue with geography chapter 3, natural resources, natural vegetation and wildlife. We have seen that natural vegetation was divided into three parts, that was forest, grassland and scrubs. So in the previous class we dealt about that the forest was further divided into or classified into three regions, that was tropical forest, temperate forest and tiger forest. In the tropical forest, we dealt about the tropical evergreen forest and tropical deciduous forest. So today we will continue with temperate forest and tiger forest. Temperate forest that lies in 25 degree to 50 degree north and south hemisphere. So this is the earth. As we know, this is the equator, 0 degree. And from which degree to which degree? It is from which degree? It is from 25 degree to, so this is 23.5 degree. So from 25 to 50 degree north, here also 25 degree south to 50 degree south. So this region is, you have the temperate forest. Temperate forest, that is in both the hemisphere it lies the, this forest is found, okay, in this region. So whatever the countries or continents which come in this region will experience or will have a temperate forest. So in the temperate forest, it is further divided into two divisions, that is deciduous forest and evergreen forest. So in the previous class, we have dealt about what is deciduous and what is evergreen forest, that is in the tropical forest. Deciduous forest are which forest? That means the trees which shed their leaves once in a year. And the evergreen forest are those trees which are evergreen. That is, they will shed their leaves but not in a particular month or a season. Okay, so evergreen forest. So temperate forest is further divided into deciduous temperate forest and evergreen temperate forest. So deciduous forest is found in the northern hemisphere. So in this region it is found. And they are these forests. The deciduous forest is grown in a moist and a warm regions, that is summer and frosty winter. That means this forest, the deciduous temperate forest. And evergreen forests are found where there is a mild climate. A mild means not very strong. Okay. So it grows, evergreen forest is grown in the mild climate where it is frost-free winters. So which are the areas it is found? Deciduous forest, it is found in the eastern North America, eastern Asia, western Europe. That is deciduous temperate forest. And evergreen forest, that is evergreen temperate forest, is found in South America, eastern Australia, southern China, Korea and Japan. So forest is divided into two regions, that is temperate forest is divided into two classification, that is deciduous temperate forest and evergreen temperate forest. So it is that this region, temperate region, is found where the winters and are mild, that is not so strong, and rainfall is moderate. And in this forest we have lots of trees, we have scrub regions and bushes. And there are important trees which are found in this region are oak, ash, peach, poplar, elm and pine. So in this temperate forest, these are the trees which are found. And in some of the areas we have done that we have deciduous trees which are replaced by coniferous trees. Coniferous trees are those trees which are tall and straight and they have needle shaped like leaves. So let's move on to the other forest, that is the tiger forest. Tiger forest lies between 50 degree north to 70 degree north. That is, you can can understand from 50 degree north to 70 degree north region. So this region you can say lies the Tiger Forest. Tiger Forest. And in this forest we get coniferous trees. They are straight and needle-like shaped structure. Leaves are needle. That means like this trees, like a cone-shaped trees. That is coniferous trees, and they are evergreen, tall, and have straight trunks with needle-shaped leaves. And in this forest, what are the trees which are found? That are dogwoods, fir, spruce, larch, and redwood. So these are the trees which are found in the Tiger Forest, and you can understand that what type of climate it would be. Little bit moderate type of climate, or you can say not extreme cold, but it will be a cold region. So in this type of forest we have coniferous trees are found. And which are the trees which are found? That is dogwoods, firs, spruce, larch, and redwood. So we'll move to the other parts of the classification of vegetation, that is grassland. Let's start with the grassland. So what do you understand by grassland? The areas having short heighted small grasses, or you can say small heighted stunt trees. Not trees, not like that wooden one, no. It will be little bit smaller in height, okay. And it grows in the region where we have the moderate type of rainfall. It will not be grown in the areas where it is heavy rainfall. It will be there, but not in that quantity. But it needs only a moderate type of rainfall. So grassland is further divided into two categories, that is tropical grassland and temperate grassland. So temperate grasslands are regions which lie in the equatorial region, that is from 0 degree to 22.5 degree north and south region. So this region we will be also getting the grassland, that is tropical grassland. And temperate grasslands are the regions which lies from 30 degree to 55 degree north and 30 degrees to 55 degree south. So this region we will be getting the temperate grassland. Okay, so this region we will be getting the temperate grassland. So we'll move each topic, that is tropical grassland. It is found in the equatorial forest and tropical desert region, that is in this region, equatorial regions, and where the regions which lies to the tropical desert region, that means where we get a very less rainfall. Okay, that region will be getting this type of grassland, that is tropical grassland. And it receives moderate rainfall during wet season, in the summer season, and they experience endemic dry season. So it is categorized by that in the rainy season it has a moderate type of rainfall, and it is found in the summer season, and it has a distinct dry season. And tall grasses, that means it is given a category that these tall grasses is called as the grassland. That means whatever the grasses which are grown in the ground, that is called as the grassland. And these grasslands are called as another name given as the savanna grassland. So in many parts of the world we are getting grasslands. Okay, every part of the earth will be having the grasslands. Where it is, you can see it in our region also, we have it, but in a very less quantity. We have grasses, but not in that much height, but it will be counted as the grasslands, but not in that distinct area. So savanna grassland is given that name, that is grassland is given another name, that is called as the savanna grassland. And savanna grassland is used for farming and even for the cattle rearing, that is for the animals, cattle rearing for the animals. They are being bred in that area or in that ground. And it is seen that these grasslands become desert because of the poor land management. So it is being distinctive are moving away, or it is becoming, these grasslands are becoming in a deserted area or converting into the desert area because of the land degradation, because of sometimes there is no water in that particular region, so it will lose its fertility of that land, and because of that it cannot grow any type of plant or grasses cannot be grown in that region. So because of that many of the grasslands are decaying its fertility, and in that region it is becoming desert region. Moving to the temperate grassland, it lies in the 30 degree to 55 degree north and south hemisphere. So this region which I have talked just now, that lies in the 30 degree of north and 30 degree of south and 55 to 55 degree south. So this region lies the temperate grassland, and in this zone it is found as a in the regions of humid coastal areas where there is little bit hot and which is near to the sea. Okay, so you can say in this regions nearby to this seas or oceans, that region will be getting the temperate grassland, and where there is mid latitude of desert, that means in the middle where the desert area is located, whether in that region nearby the desert area will be getting the temperate grassland. And the height of grasslands depends upon the rainfall, so it needs a moderate type of rainfall for the growth. And these temporary grasslands are known with different names. Okay, so the grassland is given the name, different names in different parts of our country. So that is prairies in North America. So this region is a grassland region which is called as a prairies. And then we have the pampas in the which region? South America. Steppes in the Eurasia region. In this region we'll be getting wells in the South Africa. So this region will be getting the grassland. So this is the grassland which we call savanna grassland. This region will be also be getting the savanna type of grassland, savanna grassland. And down in Australia, so this region will be getting that. And these are the grasslands which are given the names. That means they are called with these names. The grasslands are called with different names. That is, we have prairies in North America, pampas in South America, wells in South Africa, steppes in Eurasia, downs in Australia. So these are the names which are being given for the temperate grassland in other parts of the world. So we have talked about in today's session or in the class about the temperate forest, tiger forest and grassland. In the next class we will be doing about the scrubs. Thank you.